There is no need for an introduction to the Pythagoras Theorem. Everyone in their academics must have read Pythagoras Theorem, that is, length square plus height square is equal to hypotenuse square. But do you know, Pythagoras was not the first who invented this equation. Then, who and when this equation was first used? What is the Pythagoras contribution into this? In today's video, we are going to explore the origin of Pythagoras equation. So without losing time, let's start today's video. The Egyptian had a very interesting strategy to improve the stability of the pyramid's walls that originates in 2500 BC in Egypt. They used a rope with 12 knots tied evenly spaced, which resulted in the famous 3-4-5 triangle forming a 90 degree angle. Knotted cords were used by the rope stretchers who measured out the boundaries of fields in ancient Egypt. The knotted cords were 100 royal cubits in length with a knot every heath. A heath is 10 royal cubits. The rope stretchers stretch the rope in order to take the sag out it and keep the measures uniform. Let's take one example. Suppose Egyptian was creating the pyramid and they had a mechanism to pull the stone through rope already in place. So, to get the length of rope to pull the stone till the top of the pyramid, they might have used this way. Let's assume they wanted to build 150 meter high and 400 meter wide pyramid. Then the length of the rope will be 250, the output of Pythagoras equation as well. There is no doubt that Egyptians were well aware about this Pythagoras triplets, but did not used by this name, and there is no written evidence as well. There's a big probability that they had knowledge of it. We already know that each and every information in ancient Mesopotamia were written on the clay tablets in cuneiform script. Mesopotamia version of Pythagoras theorem is available on one of the clay tablets, which is believed to have been written about 1800 BC. That tiny clay tablet has a table of 4 columns and 15 rows of numbers in the cuneiform script of the period. This table lists 2 of the 3 numbers in what are now called Pythagoras triplets, that is, integers a, b, and c, satisfying a square plus b square is equal to c square. From a modern perspective, a method for constructing such triples is a significant early achievement known long before the Greek and Indian mathematicians discovered solutions to this problem. The main content of tablet is a table of numbers with 4 columns and 15 rows in Babylonian sexagesimal notation or base 60. The fourth column is just a row number in order from 1 to 15. The second and third column are completely visible in the surviving tablet. Let's take one example from above table. That tablet shows that ancient Mesopotamia people had knowledge of the Pythagorean theorem in a more general framework. But again, there's no written statement of the theorem. Indian version of the Pythagoras theorem is known as Baudhayana theorem, which is available in the Baudhayana Sulba Sutra, which perhaps compiled in the 8th to 6th centuries BCE, probably 3 centuries before the Pythagoras. There's the first explicitly written Pythagoras theorem that says, if you have a right triangle, the square of the length of the hypotenuse is the sum of the square of the length of the two legs. A rope is stretched along the length of the diagonal produce an area which the vertical and horizontal sides make together. Since the diagonal of a rectangle is the hypotenuse of the right angle formed by two adjacent sides, the statement is seen to be equivalent to the Pythagorean theorem, that is written for the first time as a theorem for a general triangle in the Sulbha Sutra of Baudhayana. At least, it is the first recorded instance. Pythagoras Theorem is in the name of Pythagoras of Samos, who was an ancient Greek mathematician and philosopher. And his statement of Pythagoras Theorem states that in a right angle triangle, the square of the hypotenuse side is equal to the sum of squares of the other two sides. The sides of these triangles have been named as perpendicular, base, and hypotenuse. If we see Pythagoras' theorem chronologically, we will find that Egyptian was the oldest one using this but did not have any connection with mathematics. Second record we find on Mesopotamia clay tablet where we see mathematic relationship between numbers. An Indian version we can see that Baudhayana proves this theorem with the help of area. And finally, Pythagoras, who proved this theorem geometrically. Who invented first? It depends on what standard we are using. If you want to be really rigorous, and who first totally understood even the proof of that, then it would naturally be the Pythagoras. I hope you liked the video, so don't forget to subscribe our channel Ancient X and hit the bell icon so that you can get the latest updates. Thank you for watching the video.